Hi, I'm Dan Wesser from PLR Planners, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to load a very large file on Etsy. As some of you may have noticed that when you're loading your digital planners onto Etsy, you get an error because you're only allowed to load 5 files that are 20 megabytes each. And of course digital planners are a heck of a lot bigger. So if you take a look at this one, my family history one, I'm going to show you how I set that up and how you can do exactly the same thing with using a file sharing site and then using a PDF that they can then download. So let's have a look. So we're going to do this My Family Good Notes Ready. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to zip the file. So if I go into my family history, there's my Good Notes family history file. So I've put some covers in there. I've got the document, which is a PDF format. I've also exported it, I brought it into GoodNotes and then exported it as a GoodNotes file. And then I have a folder JPEG, which is basically just an image of what is in there. And then over here, I have the PDF. And this PDF contains the information about the planner. So it's Legacy for Life Planners, it says thank you for your purchase, it's got a picture of what's in there. And then it says to you, you can download the files, and if you hover over the hyperlink, you will see it's got a URL. Now, I'm not going to use the same URL for this demonstration because my stuff is stored on Amazon, but you can use a site like Dropbox, which you can take a look over here. There's Dropbox. So I've created a subdirectory on Dropbox called Using a File Sharing Site for Large Files, and I'm going to zip up the file and bring it up there. Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to into my family history product, I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to then say WinZip it, okay, to Legacy for Life, GoodNotes Family History. Once that's done, you'll see there's my zip file over there. So I'm now going to drag that zip file, and I'm going to put it onto Dropbox, just like that. And now it's going to upload. Once it's finished uploading, I will then be able to get a URL or a hyperlink where I can then insert it into my Word document and then save the document as a PDF. So I'm going to say that's completed. I'm going to go to the three little dots. I'm going to go to copy link, and it's getting the link, and there's the link for me now. So all I'm going to do is right click and copy. Now when I go to my Word document, okay, so now I've got my Word document, and all I'm going to do is over here where I've said download, I'm going to right click and I'm going to say I'll remove the hyperlink, but I'm going to just edit the hyperlink, and I'm going to put in the hyperlink from Dropbox, and then I would say okay, and then I would save this file as a PDF. So I'm not going to save this particular one because it's already been done. Now if I go to the PDF, that hyperlink would be in there. And now what you're going to do is this PDF is the file that you're going to upload directly to Etsy. So let's go and have a look. So I'm going to close that down. Go to Etsy. And here I'm in the actual editing of the Family History Good Notes. So I put in all my pictures. I put in a video about the product. I've got my title and all of that, and we're not going to go into any of that now, but what I wanted to do is show you how you would do it. So I've got all my keywords in, I've got my pricing, and then over here where it says digital files, you can upload it. I'm not going to delete this one, but you would simply click on upload file and go and find your PDF. Now we've already got one there, so when they then buy this particular product, they will download the PDF, and then they will see that link where they can then go and download their stuff. So let me go back into it. So they will then download this PDF. It tells them what they've got, and then they can click on download. And also, I've included instructions. Now, what I've also done over here is I've given them links to my website, Amazon and Etsy, to our Facebook group, etc. So that is a really great way of building, getting people to your own website or social media accounts is by using the PDF format and then just giving them a download link to your product. So I hope that's helped. If you've got any questions, please feel free to ask.